Hello, my name is Mark Winarowitz. I work for the life science business of Merck KGaA, Darmstadt, Germany. I'm a research technical specialist based in Burlington, Massachusetts in the United States of America. Today, I'd like to share with you four tips and tricks that can help you save money when performing immunohistochemistry. This video is intended for an audience who is familiar with the immunohistochemistry technique. My first tip involves mounting tissue onto glass microscope slides. It's important that the tissue adheres to the slide well because this will prevent slipping or cracking during the immunohistochemistry process. Scientists typically use microscope slides that have been pre-treated with an adhesive, although these slides tend to cost more. To cut down on your costs, you can use a regular glass slide and apply an adhesive yourself in a process known as slide subbing. To perform this, take 1 liter of water and bring it to 60 degrees Celsius, and then dissolve 3 grams of gelatin type A by stirring. Once the gelatin dissolves, add in 0.5 gram of chromium potassium sulfate. When the solution settles, cool the solution to 40 to 50 degrees Celsius, and then take your glass untreated slides and briefly dip it into the solution and dry it on a piece of paper. Once they stop dripping, cover your slides and incubate overnight in a 37 degree incubator or at room temperature, and your slides will be ready to go. My second tip involves creating a hydrophobic barrier around your tissue on the microscope slides. This is important to maintain your antibody and reagent incubations during the immunohistochemistry process. Typically, scientists use a hydrophobic pen to create this barrier, although these pens can be a bit expensive. In order to save costs, you can use alternative items such as chapstick or petroleum jelly. Simply draw lines around your tissue on the microscope slide, and there you go, you have a hydrophobic barrier. The only difference with this is you want to make sure that you wipe off the excess before you start the dehydration steps and before cover slipping. So just take a chem wipe or other towel, wipe off the excess, and the remainder will clear in the xylene. My third tip or trick is a do-it-yourself histology chamber. All you need is a container with a tight-fitting lid or a tray that can be wrapped in parafilm. The purpose is to create a chamber that will maintain humidity throughout the incubation process. I've chosen to go with an old takeout delivery container that I've washed out thoroughly and have converted into a histology chamber. What you do next are you take a couple of serological pipettes. I prefer to use plastic because they're easier to cut and a lot safer than using glass. Cut them down to the size of the bottom of the container and glue them to the base. The serological pipettes will serve as a platform for the microscope slides. My fourth tip and trick is that you can reuse primary antibodies. Oftentimes people discard primary antibody after its use, but the fact is if you're using antibodies for qualitative immunohistochemistry, you can return it to a container and add in a couple drops of 0.05% sodium azide solution. Please note that you do not want to use sodium azide with fluorescent antibodies as this will quench the fluorescence. I hope these tips and tricks will help your immunohistochemistry and help you save money. Thank you and take care.